Non-stop rain means even the hardiest trees can quickly crash down and destroy everything underneath. But what happens when the tree may be on city property and you've put them on notice? One Atlanta homeowner did just that.
Since I moved here in December, I've been calling them, the forestry and everybody, to take care of those two trees because of my concern.
But Paolo Rubola said nothing happened.
I left a voicemail telling her that the tree I was talking about now was sitting on the roof of my house.
So who pays the bill? Initially, the homeowner. But Rubola wants the city to pay.
If the tree was dead or it looked like it was going to fall and he put the city on notice that they need to do something, he can hold the city liable in the event that the tree does damage his house.
Atlanta City Arborist Jason John says the Department of Parks is always on the lookout and responds quickly to tree emergencies. But if disaster strikes?
If it's a city property tree, like I said before, I always direct people to claims for damages.
And what about trees that crash down from your neighbor's yard?
When the tree comes tumbling down, who pays for the damage? In this case, the tree fell on this property. This homeowner only has to pay up to the fence, and then the homeowner next door, where the tree actually came down and caused all the damage, has to pay to get it all repaired.
That came as quite a surprise to Rico Woodard, but he says the neighbor was told the tree could come crashing down, and he wants him to pay.
I assumed the owner of the house would it would be fall on him, you know. But as I hear, it might fall on us.
For now, he does. But as with the city, there is a remedy. Neighbors put on written notice that a tree can fall, says attorney Tom Salata, can be sued for damages. From the Help Desk, I'm Bill Liss.